So I've done videos about how useful Chromebooks can be and how on a Chromebook you can do certain things that maybe you wouldn't expect. So I've done a video about editing RAW files on a Chromebook. I've done a video about editing videos on a Chromebook. And now I'm going to do a video about editing 4K footage on a Chromebook. So I'm using a service called Wevideo. And with Wevideo, you can use a Chromebook to edit video because most of the processing is done in the cloud. And a Chromebook is suitable for this. So I had a need to edit some 4K footage and my desktop machine isn't going to do very well at this. So I had a go of Wevideo and so far I've been very pleased. Now you can see the 4K video here if you are so interested. But today I'm just going to talk about using Wevideo, what I like about it, how it works and what's not so good. So here we are, we've got a standard timeline and we can upload media. Now you can upload media from cameras, you can upload media on any computer, and you can upload media from mobile devices as well, which is really useful. And it works very simply. You just import your media like so. It takes some time to process, and it took a very long time to upload 4K footage, and it took a very long time for it to process. But once it processes, you can run your 4K footage without any instance at all. And it behaves just like it would on a normal video editor. So you can do various effects, and obviously you're not going to be able to do as many effects as you can in a traditional video editor. So I can just add a vignette and a blur. One of the downfalls of Wevideo is you can't really see your end product. So I'm editing 4K footage. All I get to work on is this preview window here. I don't get anything else to work on, and I can't check the output until I've finished. So I think that is a downfall of Wevideo. Wevideo have sort of a stock library of video files, images, and audio. And you can, if you pay for the top package, you can get those, and they're called Essentials. I haven't got them. I've tried them, and I haven't gone any further with them. So when you upload a piece of media, you can start editing it straight away, which is very useful. So you don't have to wait till the upload is finished. You can start editing it from the get-go, from the start of uploading. You'll notice as well, we've got a narration button and we've got a button to do screen recording. Now, I'm actually completing this whole video on a Chromebook. So I'm using an external microphone to get good audio, but everything you're going to see today is done on a Chromebook. So what's quite nice is you get these really good titles. And here's just one that's quite impressive. Let's have a look at this. You occasionally get this, we're preparing your preview for you, when it's just doing something in the cloud and it takes a while. So obviously that's a pre-made one, but you can just edit it and you get to put in your big G photo, big G photo, and I can change the colors if I want. I'm going to say done editing. And that will behave like that. So you're not going to get the same level of flexibility as you would get with something like Final Cut Pro, Sony Vegas, CyberLink, Power Director, but you do get an awful lot, and pretty much most tasks you can do. Here we have some sound effects and we have some music. Quite a lot of music that you can get. Here we have transitions. So here's a standard cross zoom. And again, you might find you're just waiting for a preview for it to work. But I'm only encountering this when I'm using 4K footage. When I've done HD things on here, it's been fine. But like I say, you can quite easily edit 4K footage. Here we can do things like we can add in backgrounds. Most of the time you're going to add in a solid background. These don't really appeal to me, but I can see them appealing to other people. Same with the frames. And of course you can get themes. Where it's not as good as a traditional editor is if we want to do some color correcting. We can do basic rotation, flip, scaling, zooming in, zooming out. We can change the position. We can't do too much with audio levels. We can mute the audio or we can adjust the volume. We can do some animation. So we can do some Ken Burns style things. But this is a little bit limited. So we've got brightness. We don't have shadows and highlights, which would be really good. So we can easily convert things to black and white by dropping the saturation. We can make things garish. We can do a bit of white balance adjusting, but we can't use a white balance dipping tool. Same with temperature and tint. It's really important if you're filming stuff that you get the exposure correct in camera, because you're very limited in what you can do in Wevideo. You can do some green screen. I've not had a need for doing any green screen. Feedback I've seen is that the green screen works really well. Or the color keying, I should say, works really well. And you can do some speeding up and speeding down. But generally, the editing is not going to be as good as you would find in a traditional desktop-based editor. So when you want to finish, you can pick your thumbnail, give it a title. You can pick 720, 1080, and 4K, and you can export it to these platforms. So I've already linked my YouTube account, so I click here and I would click finish and it would export. In terms of what it costs, you've got your free version, and other than that, you're paying $8 a month for the unlimited, where you get 4K export resolution. These include the sort of stock footage as well. And here with business, you can have multiple people collaborating together, so that's quite good that everyone can up, if you work in a team, lots of people can upload media and lots of people can work on a project at the same time. That's not really relevant for me, and I'm not really going to use the stock footage, so this is probably the package for me. But you have to buy it sort of upfront for a year to get the best value package. So again, it's working on a subscription model, which I'm not fantastically thrilled with, a subscription model. But I've got to this stage where my desktop is creaking along and I still need to edit my YouTube videos. We get a menu down here, but it's not really too much to talk about. We can switch to something called storyboard editing, but everyone's going to want to use the timeline editing. You can add in video tracks quite easily, and you can add in audio tracks as well. So you select whether it's audio or video. And generally, I've been quite impressed with Wevideo. What's really nice is, and what I've struggled with in the past, is when I upload a YouTube video, if it's a big file, it can often go wrong somewhere in the upload process. And occasionally, I have to do it two or three times. What's nice with Wevideo is you upload your media in small bites. So you upload each file, and then that means it's there. And then when you process it, you don't have to then upload it to YouTube. It just automatically syncs to YouTube because everything's up there in the cloud. So it means for me, I'm less likely, because I'm uploading smaller files rather than one file, I'm less likely to find I'm frustrated by things not working or getting to 99% of the upload to YouTube and falling at the last hurdle. So I would recommend Wevideo, and particularly if you're doing 4K editing or working with 4K files, it's very good. Oh, one other thing I've noticed, you can add markers if you want to. I generally don't use markers, but I know some people do. There's a facility to add markers, and